Hold on, wait a second, wait a second, Dennis. So through the midst of these years, you said eventually I feel like this could turn, like we're gonna use this for the greater good. Like you had the foresight, like I mean, maybe not to the extent of where it is, but you at least had the capacity to say, like, I think we're gonna like I think we're gonna make the best out of this situation right here.
I actually did, because I actually used to dream and pray on this stuff. I actually used to say I want to be famous. So the fact the fact that I got famous that way at first without people knowing me, it did hurt, because I obviously didn't like it. And then it was like, you got what you wanted. Now hopefully it's a fame that you would like. And the fact that it became a fame that I obviously enjoy now, it's like, wow.
Welcome to Beyond the Ball Podcast.
What's going on? What's going on? What's going on, ballers? And welcome to another episode of Beyond the Ball. I'm your host, Jonathan Jones. And as you all know, we like to focus on sharing stories, strategies, and successes to help student athletes succeed beyond their degree. And, you know, this episode is going to be a special episode. You know what I'm saying? I'm excited, because I'm always a big fan of great stories and of seeing people really just out here killing it. So, man, without further ado, I'm going to go ahead and welcome Mr. Dieunrest Collin. You may have seen him on a viral meme some time ago, but this brother is so much more. So, Dieunrest, man, how you doing, brother? Welcome to Beyond the Ball.
Yeah, first off, thank you for having me. Obviously, Dieunrest Collin, I'm an offensive lineman at Lake Erie College, and I play football. So, yeah.
Yeah, man, let's get it. So, Dieunrest, man, we're gonna get into the meme. We're gonna talk about that, and I know I've talked about that often, but when people meet you for the first time, how do you introduce yourself?
usually the first thing I say is obviously, hi, my name's Dieunrest, and from there, that's all I really say. I try not to like bring up everything that I've gone through. Whether it's the meme, whether it's football. Just like to start with just my name.
Fair enough, man. Fair enough. So people are typically the one that bring the meme up to you, or this doesn't happen too often. Like when people see you out and about.
So it could. To be honest, most of the time it could go either way. Usually, they obviously know me and they say, "Oh my God, hey, you know what I mean? Can you do this or that?" Or usually when it's, I just want to break the ice, because in my heart it's like, I know you want to ask me the question, but you're kind of scared to ask me the question. I'm gonna say yeah, and I'm a meme too. And they're like, oh my God, really? And then they say, oh, I was scared to ask you and all that stuff.
I got you, man. I got you. Fair enough. So, eight years old, right? 8 years old. You're in Popeyes. You and your family. You know, y'all getting some. You're getting some dinner, right? You're going out, going out to eat, and then a guy mistakes you for little Terrio. And then he tries to get you to dance, and you try like do the dance. And I saw that you said at first when you became a meme, and when you saw what was happening, you said it made you a little bit sad. Can you just talk a little bit about that? Can you just expound a little bit on that, please, for us?
Yeah, just the fact that I was put in a spot like that I never wanted to be in at the time. Because it was like, one, I'm a 9-year-old kid still in elementary school. And the fact that I had to deal with people just bothering me, bullying me out of nowhere about it, it was like, oh, what do I do now?
I got you. And then we fast forward time. We're gonna jump forward a little bit, because not 9 years old, and then when you and your team won the state championship, then that was one time to where one of the few times, right, that you actually posted your own meme, right? And now, you know, you're saying going from Popeyes to championships, right? But Meantime and between time, like how did you cope with that? Because like I know you said you were sad, and because you were in the spotlight that you don't want to be in, but how did you deal with that, knowing that it was something that at that time it didn't seem like it was going nowhere, and you know we've still seen it 10 years later. How did you handle that? Did you talk to somebody, or what was that process?
Like I always say, while everything was going on, I met a lot of people in my life. Obviously, the first time when I met people was, oh, you're the mean kid. Oh, let's talk, bother him and all that stuff. But the fact that I want to say, X'd out everything people said, obviously. And then I would talk to them like just as Dennis himself. They found that I was a really cool guy and I was a good guy to be around. So, you know, then I would explain my part, my story to them and the effect on how I feel and all that stuff. And they will look at it like, wow, I apologize for the way I would talk to you and all that stuff. And the way I would just, you know, talk about all this stuff to you. And I would accept the apology because it's like, I want to meet new people. And I want to obviously gain friends and all that stuff. And just from there, I just grew bonds. And even with my family members, they, like I said before, they all didn't like everything. But, you know, I try to, you know, put it on them and say, hey, you may not like it. Hey, I might not like it right now, but I'm pretty sure sooner or later I'll like it. Because I've seen how every viral person, you know, was switching everything into a good thing. I said, hey, maybe one day it will happen to me. So, you know, everyone just rode the ride and, it got me here.
Hold on, wait a second, Dennis. So through the midst of these years, you said eventually I feel like this could turn, like we're gonna use this for the greater good. Like you had the foresight, like I mean, maybe not to the extent of where it is, but you at least had the capacity to say, like, I think we're gonna I think we're gonna make the best out of this situation right here.
I actually did because I actually used to dream and pray on this stuff. I actually used to say I want to be famous. So the fact that I got famous that way at first without people knowing me, it did hurt because I obviously didn't like it. And then it was like, you got what you wanted. Now, hopefully, it's a fame that you would like. And the fact that it became a fame that I obviously enjoy now, it's like, wow.
Now, wait a minute. Now, all the interviews I done watched, Dennis, I ain't heard you tell nobody that yet, man.
I mean, this is the first time I, like, you know, elaborated more.
Huh. That's dope, man. Wow. Okay. So tell us a little bit more, man. Like, I've seen you in your TikToks, and I've seen you dance, and I've also heard that you have some interest in acting. Where did this desire come from to act, and is this something that you've always kind of wanted to be in the spotlight? Because just like you said, you wanted to be famous. Talk a little bit more about that, man. Where did that come from?
So about all of that stuff, I actually, to be honest, I actually was never wanting to be an actor. I actually wouldn't, you know, do things on camera and feel comfortable on camera to the point where if people were to like maybe give me a script or maybe just tell me to do, I would feel like a natural. So the acting really wasn't a big thing for me. Like when I obviously shot the commercial with Popeyes, to be honest, at first you would think like, oh, he's not used to this, it's not gonna look good and all that stuff. But I'm so used to being on camera, it's like, hey, just make it a good thing.
Yeah, man. I mean, you look pretty relaxed. I was like, hold on, wait a minute. Because I was watching the Super Bowl and I saw the commercial. And I was like, wait, okay. And I mean, it was pretty dope. But did you have any say in the commercial? Like in terms of like the puppies or like in terms of like, did you have any creative control or any creative contribution to the commercial itself?
So I actually did the ending part where I said, do I get to keep on these puppies? Because I actually wanted to keep one of them because they're pretty cute. Pretty, pretty cute.
So did they let you keep one?
No, sadly. I was pretty upset on my flight back.
Oh man. Wow. Wow. Okay. Fair enough, man. Okay. So we talked a little bit about the acting, talked a little bit about man. Have you finally had the time to really process that you're a sponsored, I'm gonna say a sponsored person, because I know you're an athlete and I know with NIL, but your notoriety came even before NIL. It was your notoriety came way before NIL. But like, have you really been able to really process that? Wow, like I'm on a billboard from Popeyes and I'm sponsored by Popeyes.
No, it has not sunk in yet at all. That's the weird thing about it. I think it will probably sink in when I give back, like in a big way, to obviously my family and obviously to my community. So it hasn't sunk in yet. Obviously, there's still work, more work to be done. So until that happens, yeah, but it hasn't sunk in yet.
I got you, man. I got you. Talk. Okay, well, I'm gonna go here first because you said give back in a big way. Like, what would that look like to you? Like, let's just say we jump in a time machine. We move forward 5 years, 10 years, however many years. Like, you giving back in a big way, hypothetically. What would that look like for Dieunrest Collin?
Obviously, the number one thing for me is to obviously get my parents in the home and obviously move them to a place where they will enjoy. And another thing I would like to do, just because as an athlete myself, I actually want to rebuild a civic center that's actually down the street from my house, to the point where everybody can go there and train and do everything they want to do so they can prepare themselves to be better athletes for the future.
All right,
And
then.
that's something I really don't talk about. So I try, I usually try
Man.
to keep it to myself.
Fair enough, man. I love it, man. I love to I love to get the full picture, man. 'Cause yeah.
Was between like me and two other friends, my friend Damon and Kyle. All three of us, we all that was the Civic Center was actually the first weight room I was actually able to lift in to actually become like the strong athlete I am today. And I would go in there every day. Sometimes we'd be leaving there late at night, around like 9, 10. All of us just working out and all that stuff. And they had obviously they had the equipment, but now that I'm getting older and I'm seeing like what big weight rooms look like and what big facilities look like, I actually want to do that for my community so it could benefit every athlete in my city, because there's a lot of athletes in my city.
Yeah, and I mean you were able to be one, right? Coming up through the ranks and putting in work and becoming a state champion. So, you know, being able to pay it forward for others. I'm here for it, man. I'm here for it. I'm here for it. So really quick, I want to just bounce back to the Super Bowl and bounce back to Popeyes real quick. What was the growth that you saw? Either well, let me break it down like this. From before you were signed with Popeyes, right? I don't know what your Instagram numbers were. You may know, you might not have looked at it and just lost it. I don't know. But before you got signed by Popeyes, what were them Instagram numbers looking like, Dennis? What was the Instagram numbers looking like, man?
Before Popeyes, it was looking like, I believe, I don't remember about how, but I think it was like 30, 35.5K. And the fact that it actually grew from 35.5K all the way to, I think it's 93.45K now. So, yeah, it was a big growth.
Lord have mercy. You said, hold on, wait, you said 34, 35 to 90? Hey. Come on, Dennis. Oh. Oh my goodness. Wow. Okay. Man. Okay, Dennis. Huh. All right. So the first time you saw the commercial play, hey, take us to that reaction. Because I mean, of course, you're on the set and, you know, y'all doing the cut and you in the whip and everything like that, pies or fries. But when you saw the finished product, when you were wherever you were watching the Super Bowl, if you watched it, right? What did you feel?
Joy, because I like the way the product, the way everything finished. Because when I was like, obviously I was all set doing everything, I was like, how is this all gonna like coil it together? Because I'm not used to the acting business, the all this business, but it's like seeing everything come together. It was like, I literally was doing all this like literally 2 days ago. How did they create all of this in like maybe a 17 to 24 hour span? But I felt like a lot of joy just watching that.
Yeah, man. Yeah. What did your parents say? What did your parents have to say after they seen it, man? Because I know your dad got, you know what I'm saying, got a poster hooked up in the barbershop. Cause he want to inspire other people by way of his son. So what did they have to say when they got to see the finished product and everything like that?
My dad was like really, really excited for me, and I was on the phone with him. He's like, "Hey, I'm proud of you of everything you've done, you know." And he started to get really emotional, and obviously I started to get emotional. But as the person that I am, I don't. I don't usually try to show my emotions, but with that moment on the phone, we both were very emotional. And he was just saying how I'm proud of you, and this is only the beginning. And him saying that made me think like it really is just the beginning, you know, it's more to it.
Yeah, man, I'm excited for you too, man. I mean, I don't know what the future holds, but you know, with you going back to what you said earlier, with you having the foresight, even going through the midst of, you know, something that seemed very tough when you were a youth, because I mean, that's bullying at its finest. And we've seen here in the past 5-10 years people taking their life by way of stuff that was said over social media. And I mean, I can't imagine all the ways you've seen the meme used and everything like that. But for you to, you know, have your faith game tight, and for you to be like, man, something else is gonna come from this. And then it came around, didn't it? You said, wait a minute. You said, hold on, wait. Everybody else taking advantage of this. Let me get my piece too. Yeah, man. Yeah. So last Popeye's question. Why am I asking two more Popeye's questions?
Mm-hmm.
But when you sat there and said, when you sat behind the keyboard and you was like, wait a minute, I need to shoot my shot with Popeyes. Walk us through that thought process. Like, what was it that built up to give you the audacity to say, hold on, Popeyes, y'all gonna talk to me?
I was actually on my way home from winter break, and this is really weird, but I really have to really thank SportsCenter's Instagram page for actually everything, because they posted it on their page, and I seen it. I was like, oh, wow. They posted it. I'm surprised they remember, because it was actually going on from like a year from that day when everything, you know, popped off and all that stuff. And, you know, I had people texting me, telling me, oh, my God, SportsCenter posted you again. And it's crazy and all that stuff. And then it was actually one person specifically who told me, hey, man, you're wasting time. You need to get on this now. He's been on me since I won the state championship, and even before. I'm actually one of his brand ambassadors, E-Man, lock in. He told me, hey, you have to take advantage of this now. Like, right now. SportsCenter posted it. Everybody's liking it. I believe it will hit over 1 million again. And I said, all right. Obviously, I didn't know how to approach it. But I said, hey, we just gonna make a post on Instagram. Obviously, you see what the following you have now. We're going to make a post on Instagram. We're just going to see what's going to happen from there. Hopefully, all the followers that I have support me. And from there, not only did the people that followed me support it, it was people outside of my following that actually supported me. And, you know, that was texting me saying, hey, I'm with you on this one. Like, I think they should definitely do this, because this is going to be the best move they've done. And I agree with them, and yeah, it's looking like the best to me. It's looking like the best.
Yeah. Most definitely, man. I mean, because the last brand ambassador I knew they had was the sister who was, she was known for like the Southern home cooking. But I mean, I think she just did a great job in the commercial. I don't know if they took it any further than that, but I mean, by far for me, you're the face of Popeyes. So
thank you.
Yeah, man, you the face of Popeyes. I don't got, there's no debate about it. there's no debate about it, bro. So I've seen you doing the dances. I watched some of your TikToks. I saw you do the day in the life of a D2 athlete and everything like that. Where did the nickname come from of the killer whale? I know I'm missing a word in there, but help me out, man. Where does nickname come from, man? And give us the real nickname. My apologies.
Gotcha. So obviously I call myself the King Killer Whale. It's actually one of the things in my freshman year. So it was actually my teammates coming up to me, you know, saying, because I had my equipment on and all that stuff. I believe we just came from practice. And they said, oh my God, you look like a gorilla in your equipment. And I said, I mean, gorillas are obviously very dominant, but I want to be something very different. And I'm like, they're telling me like, what do you mean by different? I'm like, I don't know, something really different. And somebody told me, maybe you look like a whale. I'm like, if I'm going to be a whale, I'm going to be a killer whale, obviously. And obviously I did my research on it right after that day. And, you know, from that day on, I just stuck with it because I like the way it sounded and everything.
Killer whales are ferocious, man.
Definitely.
Killer whales are ferocious, so I'm here for it, man. I'm here for it. All right, we're gonna go ahead and transition now. We're gonna transition to where we're gonna do the rapid fire segment of the show. This is where I'm just gonna ask you just a couple of questions, and I just want you just to share the first thing that comes to your mind. Dennis, are you ready?
Always.
What is your go-to for self-care?
Music.
Who's your favorite artist?
Don't have one. I have an open ear.
Oh, what's your favorite genre of music though?
Open ear, doesn't really matter.
What are you listening to now?
What am I listening to now? R&B.
Fair enough. Books or podcasts?
Podcasts. Not a reader. Sorry.
Fair enough. Give me your top three podcast.
I Am Athlete. I watch I Am Athlete, The Pivot, and I watch OG. He's a TikToker. He's a sports TikToker.
Okay, fair enough. What's your favorite movie? Like, give me your top three.
Top three? Okay, so I'm a Marvel guy. So, obviously, I'll probably go X-Men. Just rewatched it this week. I would go Captain America, Winter Soldier, and Captain America, Civil War. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm leaving out Black Panther. Can't leave that out.
Yeah. Fair enough. See, man, that was harmless. That was harmless. So, since you said you're a Marvel guy, have you seen the new Ant-Man?
No, I have not. Please don't give me any spoilers. I want to watch it in the theaters.
No. I don't do those. It was pretty good. That's what I'm gonna say. It was pretty good. All right. Okay. So now we're at the segment I like to call the winner's circle of the week. Okay. Mm. And this is the opportunity for you to shout out. You can shout out a student athlete. You can shout out a teammate. You can just shout out somebody that you know that's doing really amazing things, or you just feel that they've been flying under the radar. And you're like, this person has been putting in work. I co-signed this person and you should interview them next. If you were to say a person, who would that person be for you, Dennis?
Okay. This is going to be, it's hard because I have a lot. But it's actually one person who I actually just finished getting in contact with the other day. Joshua Richards, wide receiver for Maryland in the future.
Oh. Okay, that's what's up. Well, and why you say him?
Cause throughout like obviously years, he's an under the radar receiver. Right now, I believe he's ranked a 3-star, which I find blasphemy. I think he should be ranked a 5-star because he's that good. And he actually just finished a basketball season. Obviously, it ended the way they wanted to, but he's going through a lot. And the fact that he's going into college, I just want to give him his props for everything he's done in high school based off what I've seen.
Fair enough, man. Fair enough. Fair enough. So I got two more questions and we wrapping this thing up. We putting a bow on it and you getting out of here, man. Because you're a student athlete. You got stuff you got to do. So I'm curious to hear from you. What's one question that nobody has ever asked you, but you wish that they would?
Okay. All right. It's a good one. I want to say, do you have any talent outside of football? Just that one question.
Do you have any talent outside of football, Dennis?
Yes, I do. I actually have a lot. But obviously, my main one, which used to be my main one, but I'm trying to get back into it now here. I was in a choir. I was a tenor. I was a singer. Yeah. Weird to say.
Yeah. And you're currently listening to R&B, so I see. I see what you did there. Well played, man. Oh, man. Well, Dennis, man, before we get into the last question, just let people know where they can find you, how they can follow you, and how they can stay connected with you in your journey, man, please.
Obviously, you can stay watching me on my Instagram. I try to stay on TikTok a lot, obviously. I'm starting to get into YouTube, which is very hard because I'm not the best editor. But I'm still learning with that. And I am a streamer. I stream me playing video games. So you can go ahead and watch me do that.
Fair enough, man. Fair enough. We'll make sure to get your links down there in the show notes and everything like that. And Dennis, man, I'm make sure to get you. I'm going to help get you right on YouTube, man. I'm going to help get you right on YouTube for sure. But Dennis, man, this is the final segment of the show. Take us home. This is our Dear Student Athlete segment. So for either aspiring or a current student athlete, man, what's just your word of wisdom? What insight would you like to share with them? It can be about anything, whatever's on your heart, man. Just please feel free to share at this time.
I want to say, make your experience what you want it to be. Because obviously, first thing when you come to college, especially as an athlete, first thing you think is, oh, I'm just going to be straight athletics and all that stuff. But obviously you have to be on your athletics, but let's not forget about school, because obviously you want to get your degree and you want to finish school with a purpose. You don't want to just go there and be like, I was just here for football, that's it. You want to finish school with a purpose. And you know, I also want to say, have a little fun. Not too much fun, but have some fun. So yeah.
There it is, folks. There it is, man. That's gonna wrap up this episode of Beyond the Ball. Man, shout out to Dieunrest Collin for coming through the show, showing love, and man, getting it. We got some exclusives on the show today, man. So it's pretty dope to know. Shout out to Dieunrest, man. Make sure y'all subscribe to the channel and stay tapped in for more content. And until next time, this is Beyond the Ball, where we help you succeed beyond your degree.